Well, hello there. I'm Green Deane. Welcome to my 24th video here at EatTheWeeds.com. And to do something different, because this is my 24th video, my two dozen, I'm actually kayaking on the Wekiva River and the Little Rock Springs Run. So what I'm going to do today is just point out a variety of plant life, etc., as we go along, and hope you enjoy it. Then we'll do a bit of a roundup, and most of the plants I'm going to talk about today you can find on my website. So let's go see what we got out here. All along here is nice examples of hydrocaudal. I think that's umbellata. There are three. Oh, there goes a snowy egret. There are three types of these in Florida, and I just did a blog on them. Pardon me, I gotta put my paddle in the water. And they're all in the carrot family. So on this side, we're passing Scripsis bulrush. They're, if I remember correctly, it's been a long time since I've seen them. You can get sugar from the roots. Growing nicely all along here, the tall, skinny ones with the tufts on top. Of course, over here on the other side is the traditional cattails, cat o' nine tails, the supermarket of the swamp. I don't know if you can hear that or not. All those bees. The Dahoon holly tree, I think, in blossom, and the bees are just having a field day. And there we have a stand of sawgrass. Yeah, nice part. The sawgrass has edible little parts in the bottom. Well, we're passing a few interesting things here at the moment. If I can get my paddle to move here. There's a bay tree for bay leaves, swamp bay. These are some natural grapes, not muscadines, native grapes. And this is the Myrica cerifera, wax myrtle, again with some natural grapes on it. And I've got a maple branch coming my way, so I had better paddle. Here's a nice nuphar about to open. Hydrocaudals. Another nuphar. Little nuphars all along here. See, the current here is 3 or 4 miles an hour. The source of water is about 7 miles from here, and it's a spring. You can read about it on EatTheWeeds.com. Just type in Rock Springs Run. There's a nuphar. Look at that. Well, I intentionally ran aground here just for a moment to look at some pickerel weed. It'll have, see these lovely purple blossoms here? They'll have seeds later on this season, edible seeds. Egret. Better watch where I'm going. Oh, look at all the ibis here. They're fairly tame, I think, in the state park. Quite a few of them there. They're walking on mats of hydrocaudals. Oh, decided to fly. I've run myself aground in this patch of water hyacinths, so I can stop and show you what they look like. I picked them up and put it on the kayak here. When they're young, and so that means smaller than this, such as some of these over here, you can cook them, chop them up, cook them, make them fairly nice green. They don't get too tender, but you can eat them. If you eat them raw, they'll make you itch. You don't want to do that. Although some people can reportedly eat them raw and not itch. And also these little parts down here, when they're young, the floats, you can deep fry them, and they're almost like pork rinds or something like that. What we have here is a nuphar root that is broken loose. This is the water lily root against a piece of wood here that not too, you know, it's reported to be edible. But I've never been able to make one edible. It just has so much tannic acid in them, but who knows, maybe you can. Well, we're coming upon a Myrica cerifera. I've mentioned that before. It's a wax myrtle tree. You can use the leaves for seasoning. The Indians smoke them. And you can also use the berries for seasoning or for their wax. They're quite versatile. And you can also rub them on you. And they're fairly good drive-away insects. Anyway, here we have more wild grapes going by. You can tell the wild grapes because the tendril only has one. Whoops, I got a second here. Gotta get out of the way of this log. And a little fish going through there. If you can see him or not. Yeah. And I gotta paddle just a little, or I'm gonna go off course. Nice ibis. Not too afraid of me. then again, no one is. Oops. We run aground. This happens to be the common palm tree, except this one is down in the water, but it has edible berries. The fruit on them is only paint thin. You can see some there, but the stones can be ground up into a flour. And of course, the heart of the tree can be made into a disc called heart of palm. What we're approaching now is the southern equivalent of a ironwood or hornbeam. And you can always tell it by the very sinuous looking bark that it has. And here we have a lovely little patch of water hyacinths. Of course, they're a noxious weed here in Florida, but quite edible if you know how to prepare them. And behind them, there are some, pardon the paddle, there are some wild grapes. That looks like a stinging nettle, but I don't think it is. And of course, right here is a huge pile of poison ivy growing out here over the water. And I guess we better drift by that before we get any closer. Don't need a poison ivy in the boat. This is not a plant I would expect to find in this area. This is a paper mulberry tree. Notice it has a leaf that has a mitten on the right. Here's a leaf that has no, well, what I mean is it has a thumb on the on what we would call our right or this left. Has no thumb this one. And over here I think there's one that has the thumb on the other side. That's very characteristic of mulberries. So there you have it, a paper mulberry. Its fruits are very different than the other mulberries, and until recently it was actually classified in the mulberry family, but now it's not, but it's still edible. And here in fact we have a smilax sitting on the paper mulberry. So there you got two edibles when the mulberries and fruit. You can just come pick the smilax and have the tip too. And of course, this is something I would expect to find here. That's an elderberry bush. Yes, sir, great pies out of elderberry. And you also eat the flowers. Here's something you don't see too often. You know what that is? That's watercress. Nasturtium officinalis, I believe. This is the guy, I just beached my canoe, my kayak in it. But there it is. Prime edible. Yes, sir. Look at that huge amount of it. Wow. Take some of that home and put it into, the water's fairly wholesome here, but I think it's probably better off cooking it to get rid of any diseases and germs, but wow, look at that. Yeah. Well, down from the boil, see this entire river, I'm about to give you a 360 degree here. This is a little sinkhole south of the boil. This entire boil, all this river is fed by one spring right up there. The water's pretty clear. So what I'm going to do is put you in a little casing and see if we can see underwater. I don't want to fall in though, so let's keep it dry. Well, I'm Green Deane. I hope you enjoyed my trip up to the Wekiva and the Little Wekiva and back down Rock Springs Run. I thought we saw a lot of plants. Most of them were edible, a couple of them, weren't. You can go to my website, eattheweeds.com, and check on the archives and look up a lot of the plants that I mentioned. We're out here on the Wekiva, and this is my 24th video, and that's why I did it out here. Just to give you an idea that, you see, where water is, food is, whether it's plants or turtles or deer or whatever, and alligators. So until next time, I'm Green Deane. I want you to think green, I want you to eat green, and enjoy the greenery.